Hello and welcome. This is Nina from Nina Hobby Site and this is Vlogstop number 37. Today I want to show you my 10 work in progress cross stitch projects, 2 knitting projects and 1 highly recommended book that I read. I really enjoy that book, so I want to tell you a little bit about it. And I want to say in Norway it's very warm weather today. And it's also very warm in the house, but I think it's my last opportunity to film without my children around me. So I want to do it today because on the end of this week, my son has start holiday, summer holiday. So I think it's better to film now. And my last video that I make was 35 days ago, I think. So I have, I think, enough to show you. So I think I do it today. But I want to say first, thank you for all the great comments last time. I really enjoy the comments. Thank you very much. And I think let's start it with my first project. Today I have a lot of Heaven and Earth designs to show you. I really enjoy a Phil Coffitz project. But my first project is the Birds, Butterfly and Bloom, Bloom's World Map. And here is how it will look when it's finished. And here is how it looked last time that you saw it. And I don't know if I say it, but it's from Amy Stewart. It's an Heaven and Earth design and I stitched this one on 25 count. And I stitched this time 1020 stitches. And here is how it looked now. I really enjoy this piece. I really enjoy the colors. It's, yeah. And not a lot of background, so immediately you stitch something and I really enjoyed it. I really liked it. And this time I stitched, I think, a little bit on the yellow flower. And the brown, what you see, is the bird that is coming along. And I really enjoy this. But this project is still on 1.40%, so I have a long way to go. But I really enjoy this. But the fabric is a little bit weird. It's so soft that almost the thread is not staying on it. It's sometimes going through the fabric. I don't know which brand it is. I have no idea, but it's very soft. So I think my crosses look not so good because it's also a little bit confetti. But I really enjoy confetti, so it's not a problem. I prefer confetti much more than block stitching. And then my next project is my all-time favorite, is a stitching cell supersized max color from Amy Stewart from Heaven and Earth Design. And here is how it will look when it's finished. And here is how it looked last time that you saw it. And I stitched this one as well on 25 count. I stitched all my four covers with four crosses because half crosses, yeah, somehow it's not for me, not so clear. Cross stitching is much more fun for me, so I stitched all everything with four cross. And I did on this piece 733 stitches. And here is how it looked now. And yes, I love this piece. And I know it's dirty, I know. But I think I can wash it out. And I really enjoy this. This time I stitch a lot on the self. And on the queen around the lantern. And a little bit on the bobbers because I really enjoy that color. So I stitch a little bit more on that. And I'm still stitching on this because it's in my rotation and I can't wait to stitch this evening more on this. But it's slow going because it's a lot of confetti and it's max colors, so it's have 238 colors, I think. But I really enjoy this. Also, I like to do the green. But I think because it's almost page finish around, I think here. I do the large pages because it motivates me to do a little bit more because you have much faster finish. And I think maybe I start then on this page because there is a bird and I really enjoy to stitch a bird as well. And I am on 5.13% on this project. And my next project is modern folk embroidery, the Salve from 2021, I think, yes. And it's the Fruit of Plenty, and I want to make it in a wedding piece. So I choose a different motif, but here's how it will look when it's finished. And here is how it looked last time. I stitched this one on 32 count Belfast Naturel Zwijgaard linen. And I used the colors DMC 3685 and DMC 3687, yes. But here is how it looks now. I think it's coming along, and every time when I stitch more on it, I really like it more. I really like pink, I think. So it's perfect. And I stitched this time 1088 stitches. And I don't have the percentage because I did another motif. The motif right here. I hope I can show you this. It's in the chart. He give choices to modern folk embroidery. Give choices to do different blocks there. But I really enjoy this with the two birds and the heart. So I stitch on this. This on the last time. But it's much more stitching than you think, because when I see the block, I think, oh, I can finish that in 1000 stitches. But no, I am on the halfway, I think. But I really enjoy this. I can't wait to finish this, but I think maybe 2024. I try to put this a lot on in my rotation to make a lot of progress. I stitch this one 2/2 because it's... Sorry for closing the zip. And my next project is the Sunflower Cottage Mini from Donna Kelsinger. And here is how it will look when it's finished. And here is how it looked last time. I did not a lot of stitching on this, but I really enjoy this piece because it's so summery. So I want to stitch on it, so I stitched a little bit on this. And here's how it looks now. I stitched 275 stitches on this project. And I think I did a lot of yellow. Here and here. And I reached the 11.70%. And yes, I enjoy this color so much. And I really enjoy this piece. And I stitched this one on 18 count, so very easy. And I really love that. It's not big. For a heaven and earth, I think, because I stitch super size and a lot of regulars, but this is, I think, the only mini that I have, so it's not so big. And my next project is the Peasants of Kaya. My second oldest My second oldest project, and it's from Josephine Wall and an Heaven and Earth design as well. And here is how it will look when it's finished. And here is how it looked last time that you saw it. And this project. I stitch on the oldest whip Wednesdays. Oldest whip Wednesdays. So only on a Wednesday I put a few stitches in. And this time I stitch only one Wednesday on it. So I stitch only 124 stitches. But I reached the 15.31%. And here is how it looks now. So I don't think you see a lot of difference. But yes, I am glad because I am almost finished with the DMC 939. So that is, and I tried now to finish this. I try to show you, but I try to finish this this page. So then I have a page finish. So that's always nice. I really enjoy page finish. And this is one on 18 count, and I don't know if I say it, but it's from Josephine Wall. And they say all the time, there's a lot of confetti, but this piece, this toothpaste is not a lot. It's a lot of DMC 929. So it's a lot of the same block stitching. But I can't wait to start the next row. And for me, it works very well to stitch on Wednesday on my oldest project. And after 1000 stitches, I switch to my second oldest project. And on the moment, I stitch on this piece on my second oldest project. I close again the zipper, so sorry. And my next project is the Africa Mammals from Cero Machetti. It's the regular size with the max color. And here is how it will look when it's finished. And here is how it looked last time. And oh, I forget her name, Laura. From Stitching Colors, I think. Stitching Colors is stitching this piece as well, but she starts in the middle above, and then she immediately stitches the lion and a little bit of elephant ear. And it's great to see. So if you don't see that, you have to go to her channel, because yes, it's really awesome. And she stitches in my a lot on it, because she stitches only on that piece, I think. So she is on 10%, I think. She's really far with it. I'm not so far. I'm still busy stitching on the bird legs, on the flamingo legs. I stitched on this project 1105 stitches. And now I have 4 bird legs. And next time I think I stitch on the white bird. And then I go to the flamingo, but I think it's a little bit high when I do 1000 stitches. I don't think I reach immediately the flamingo, but maybe I can try. So this is almost on 2%, it's on 1.93%. But this is totally different for me, because the colors are really different than what I mostly stitch. But I really enjoy this piece as well, maybe because it's different colors, I don't know. And I stitch this one on 25 count. And 1/1. Everything on 25 count, I stitch 1/1, all four crosses. And on 18 count, I stitch 2/1. But yeah, I really enjoy this piece, but I know it's a little bit boring. I have to go to the flamingo and then you'll see more. Now I say all the time when I show this to her, yeah, you have to stitch on the flamingo. But yeah, I am always afraid when I stitch first the nice things, the things that I like, that I'm really bored with the background. So I try to stay in line. And also, I'm not so good when I have too much white spaces between, then I lost count. And yeah, I really enjoy this method. So I'm going slowly to the flamingo. But one day I'm stitching the flamingo, or maybe the lion, but I don't know. That's far away. And my next project is a non-full coverage project. I know I stitch a lot of full coverage, but this time a non-full coverage project. And it is the mini fillets from Soda Stitch. And here is how it will look when it's finished. And here is how it looked last time. And for me, this is as well a very holiday piece, and I really enjoy it. I stitched on this project 762 stitches. And here is how it looks now. Now, it's linen, 36 count, I think, 2/1. No, 2/2. But you see 2/8, so I'm going to fold it up. So, and here is how it looks now. I stitch on, I forget again the word, candy, not candy floss, I don't know, but I stitch here, and I finished the guy and the horse, a little bit, he is coming a carousel with horses, and a little bit of the trees. And yes, I really enjoy this. This is so much fun, the colors, and the little people. And yeah, I really enjoy this piece. I really like to stitch on this. And very fast you finish the little thing. And that is totally different from my full coverage project, because then I can stitch more than 1,000 stitches on background and you see nothing. And here you see really fast progress. So yes, I really enjoy this. I think this was 36 count or something, or 32. Everything is falling down next to me. I try to put, when I show you my projects, I try to put it on a chair, but it's falling down. And my notes are over here. And my next project is as well for coffee projects. And it's the Love Letters chocolate shop that I started last year. But I didn't stitch a lot on it. And here is how it will look when it's finished. About many years, I think. Because this is as well a very big piece. And I really enjoy to see other stitches. To stitch the sunset or the sky. And some people are stitching already the bike. And but I'm still in the background on the floor. And I stitch... did I say it? Here's how it will look last time that you saw it. And this piece is as well from Amy Stewart from Heaven and Earth Designs. I know a lot of Amy Stewart, but I really enjoy her pieces. I stitched 1066 stitches on this project. And here is how it looks now. And I think here is a bird coming, and maybe there, but I don't know for sure. But I am on 0.65%. So almost nothing, but... But I really enjoy this. I really love the colors, and it's confetti, so it's always okay to stitch. But I have to stitch more on it. But I have, I think, too many projects. I really enjoy it, but I really enjoy to switch between my projects and to choose which project I want to stitch on. But sometimes my projects are not growing fast enough, but I think every stitch is has that. And then my next project is the Bird Song from Tatiana Fedorova from Heaven and Earth Design as well. And here is how it will look when it's finished. And here is how it looked last time. And I stitched on this project because it's my oldest project on Wednesdays. And when I reach the 1000, I switch to my second oldest project. And this is the project... the first Heaven and Earth that I ever started. And I had 14 count fabric. So I was thinking I do it on 14 count. And now it's really, really big. But I still love it and I want to make a wall hanger with a wooden frame. So I still stitch on it. And I did this time 1066 stitches on it. And I reached the 23.40%. And here is how it looks now. It's really big. It's almost impossible to show you in frame. It's impossible, I think, but I stitched. It was fun stitch this time. Because I stitched on the... I tried to fold it, but it's so big. It's a little bit crazy, but yeah, I still enjoy it, so by, that's why I stitch on it. But I was saying, I stitch a lot on the red and the pink flowers and the purple flowers, and I really, really enjoy that. I can't wait to stitch more on it. And I don't think I can reach the 25% this year, but I'm going to try, because I really love this. And I know it's way too big. I don't think I ever going to start something else on 14 count from Heaven and Earth Design. But I really enjoy this. So I'm going, I hope, one day to finish this. And my last project is not from Heaven and Earth, but still a full coverage project. And it's the Midnight Poppy Field from Contemporary Cross Stitch. En van Amy Mustonen, I hope I say it right. But here is how it will look when it's finished. And here is how it looked last time. I stitched not a lot on it. I think I stitched for a challenge on black. And I did 283 stitches. This is going to be a big poppy flower. And for me, this is the first time to stitch on a chart from a contemporary cross stitch. And I really enjoy it because it's not block stitching, but still it's a little bit of the same color. So it's, yeah, for me, it's going fast. And I reached the 0.88%. I almost have to laugh when I say that because everything on the 1% it's not feeling if like I started it. I stitched this one on 25 count. And of course I want to stitch more on it, but I don't know when. But I really enjoy this piece. I do challenges on Facebook group, and in the weekend sometimes they have kind of pop-up surprise weekend, and then you stitch on colors. And this time it was on black, and then I stitched for 1-2 days on that project, and then I switched back to my rotation because I try to stitch this year on every project, so that's a little bit of my rotation. And then I have my plans. First I want to show you my two new Heaven and Earth designs. The first one is my pink garden, of course, from Amy Stewart. I really love Amy Stewart, and I think it's perfect because I really like pink. And yes, I really enjoy flowers and butterflies and birds. I know. And here is how it look. And the second one I get from a rack, a random act, kindness, something. I really enjoy that I get it from someone. And it is the Halcyon Nights from Josephine Wall. And when I finished the Presence of Gaia, because the colors are a little bit the same, then I want to start that one. I don't know if I can say her name, so I say only that I get it from someone. Thank you very much, really nice. And then I have my plans. So sorry, I had to pause because everything was falling on the chair and falling on from the chair to the ground. And it was a little bit of mess. But here I am again. I want to tell you a little bit about my plans in July. I want to do Christmas in July because I really love and enjoy Christmas. So I want to do that in July. And I have three pieces for Christmas, so I like to show you this. And my first one is the Christmas Village from Tiny Modernist. And here is how it will look when it's finished. And here is how it looks now. And this is like a little bit like the Soda Stitch Mini Village. It's little pieces and with the people. And I really enjoy this. So I want to stitch more on this piece. Otherwise they are only get progress in November and December. And I really enjoy all my Christmas pieces. So I want to stitch more on it. It's oh, I forgot to tell you. It's the fabric is from Zwijgaard. It's the painted. It's only on the right side is the little bit of I lost the word, but a little bit of variegation, and on the back side is only gray. But it's the one that you can wash. And my next one is the full coverage piece, is the cluster from Pain Free Crafts. And here is how it will look when it's finished. And I stitched this one, the fabric is 18 count Aeda. And it's strange, I don't think it's Zwijgaard or something, because I have a black dog and every fur is hair is on sitting on this project. I don't know why. I try many times to get the hair off, but it's like a magnet for dog hairs. It is horrible. But I hope when I wash it and frame it, that it's also hard to show you today. It's I only stitching on the background. I started in the middle. And this is the buildings and the tower. And somehow how my light is also going bad, but yeah, now you can see it, I think. And I really want to stitch more on this. I get this project, I won a giveaway from Cat Talks. So I really enjoy this piece. And my last Christmas piece is from White Raven Patterns on Etsy. And it's the Christmas sweets. And here is how it will look when it's finished. And here is how it looks now. And I stitched this on a fabric, I think 36 or 32, but it's with gold glitter. And I try to finish this maybe next year, because I want to make a Christmas project bag. And I have to finish the cup and then two cookies below it. And I really enjoy this piece as well. This is also a piece that I can bring with me, because it's on paper, so yeah. And not a lot of colors. And then in June, we have a little bit left. I have a little bit of a, not a problem, but I was thinking about the ever-flowering garden from All Forest Embroidery. I started on a piece that I have at home. And I don't think this fabric is for me. It's so stiff. It's linen, and I enjoy mostly linen, especially with samplers and yes, things like that, and with mirror beads. I really enjoy that. But this, I don't know, and I don't know if I be so happy on the color. It's really yellow, and it's so stiff. And I started this last year, and I put 1,000 stitches in, and I think it looks fine. I try to show you, but I can't almost fold the fabric, so stiff is it. And I think it looks fine, but it's a big piece, the Everflowering Garden. Here is how it will look. Very big piece. Almost so big as an Heaven and Earth design. And I don't know, I think this is 32 or 28 count. But I don't think I'm happy with this. I really like the chart and I really like the colors. But I never get it out of closet to a stitch on it. And then I found a fabric in my stash. So, and then I'm back. With a very noisy plastic bag, but I want to show you the color. I found this and I think it's big enough. It's a little bit pink, peachy, I don't know. It has a little bit of color, but I think that's perfect, because in the pattern there is white as well. And if I choose white, then I don't think you can see the colors. When I choose a white fabric. So these are the colors. So what do you think? Do you think it's nice on a pink fabric? Or it's too much? I also have a blue fabric. But then I don't think you can see this kind of blue. So I think this is okay. But it's a little bit strange to do. I see the... it's not a traditional sampler, but... yeah, for me it's a little bit traditional, so mostly I choose the white or the cream or the beige fabric. But I think for this time, maybe it's good to have a little bit of color. It's not pink, but it's, yeah, I don't know if I can show you the color. These are the colors that the pattern is using, not a lot, but I think, yeah. Every color is very visible, so. But what do you think? It's always a hard decision to do something totally different than everybody else. I never see this pattern on a pink Well, pink is fabric. But I think, yeah, I really like it. And it's 25 count, so I can stitch one over one for a cross. So it's not going to be so big as the, how do you call it? I think my grandmother calls this cheese fabric or something. It's really stiff. And it's almost a little bit sticky. I don't know. I'm not a big fan of it. But I want to try it when I had it at home, so I started on this piece, on this fabric, but I think I'm not so happy with it. And then I have a little bit of knitting. I first have a finished object. I knit the Oslo Hat Mohair from Petite Knit, and with Sandnes Karn Sunday and the Thin Silk Mohair. Adult medium, and the colors are lis, lila, and light crocus, and I really love this color. I think it's very beautiful. It's always for me so much harder to show knitting than cross stitching, maybe because I don't show a lot of knitting on my channel, but I really enjoy to knit as well. It's a very warm hat. Because you stitch this two times, double trim, and then you fold it. So you have three layers on your ear, on the ears. But, and then with the mohair, you can see it's very fluffy. And yeah, it fit me really well, but I think it's now in this room 26 degrees or 25 degrees, so I don't want to... wear it or put it on my head because it's really warm here, but I really like this color. I have almost the same color jacket, so I think it's perfect, but not for this weather. But I really enjoy to knit this. It's very easy, it's very cozy knit. I really enjoy it, and I want absolutely make more of the knitted hats from the same pattern. I also have a half finished object, that is our socks, and I forget my sock blocker, but I think it's alright. It's the Rhinebeck Roomies from the Crazy Sock Lady, and I knit this on 2.25 millimeter, and I did 72 stitches, and here is how it looks. And yes, it's really neon, the green neon, the tool and the heel. I really like this, and as well I really enjoy this structure knit. It's fun knit. I can remember it. It's very I really enjoy it. Her patterns are very good, I think, from the Crazy Sock Lady. See, now I have on the moment the summer sock camp, and I started as well the second sock. So sorry. I'm already on this. I think I'm almost halfway on the leg part. I really enjoy long legs because in Norway it's cold in the winter, so it's always better to have a little bit of long leg. The yarn is from I look in my notes. Matuska yarns. And this is the very, very green neon. It's a mini. It's a sock set. And this is the pink. And this is the pink that I love. You can see it on my nails and my dress. I really enjoy this. So I really, yeah. And for summer, I really like to knit on socks. I really enjoy that because I can do it outside when the children are in the swimming pool or in the sand. So I really like that. And then I read one book. I read The Silent Patient. And here is how the cover look, the front and then Dutch cover, because I read in Dutch, but it's almost the same cover this time. And this is a psychologic thriller. It's about Alicia, she shoots her husband, And then she never speaks a word again. And then there is Theo, and it's a criminal psychotherapist, and he tried to get her talking. But it's the final plot twist is really good. So yes, I really enjoy that read. I read very fast through the book, and there's always a good sign, because I really want to know how it ends. And yes, it's a really good book. When you like psychological thrillers, then I highly, highly recommend this one. It's almost so good as the what I recommend last time, the Housemaid from Frida McFadden. But this is a little bit different, but I really enjoy this. And The Silent Patient from Alex Michaelides, I don't know, I can't say names. But I really enjoy that book. And then I have two shout-outs. One is for a new Dutch vlogtyper, Hanneke. She has beautiful projects, and she has one framed last time. I think she has already made two videos. And she started her first full coverage project. And I'm really curious if she like the full coverage, and if she going to stitch more full coverage. Because I really enjoy them, but she is very brave, I think, because I don't know how long she is stitching, but she changing colors, and she have a beautiful project. So I highly recommend her. And I do the oldest WIP Wednesdays, and I think the one woman that started with it is The Adventures of Stitching, is her channel name, Alicia. And I really enjoy her floss tube. She's very happy person, and she has a lot of beautiful full coverage projects and with great progress. And yes, I really enjoy her, so I highly recommend it as well. And then I think I said everything that I have to say today. Only I put a few videos after this about the nature in Norway, and the dog got a new ball, and the kitten, the cat, is very busy with it, so I think that's funny as well, so I put it behind it. I have to say sorry, I always film the wrong way somehow, so my little clips are always the wrong side, but I hope it's okay. And then I have to say, have a good summer holiday if you go away or stay at home, and take care of yourself. And I don't know when I come back, because I think I'm not going to stitch so much, because the children are at home and it's summer and I'm busy with them, of course. So I don't know when I come back, but I hope soon, after a month or maybe 2 months, I don't know, but you see me when I put something up. Take care, have a good day, and happy stitching, of course. Thank you very much for watching, bye!